Students of English literature, today our topic is the judgment seat of Vikramaditya, and we are going to study lecture 4 part 4 in this English version lecture. Students, this chapter, the judgment seat of Vikramaditya, written by Sister Nivedita, is from supplementary reader class 10th. Students, in lecture 3 we came to know that when the king was going to sit on the judgment seat, there came an angel out of the base of the seat and reject the seating of the king and fill you into the sky. Now let's see what happens to the king and to the seat. Let's begin with lecture 4. The king prepared himself with prayer and with fasting. Students, as you know, the angel who appeared from the seat instructed the king of Ujjain to go back and to keep fasting and praying for more 3 days, and then he could come back. The king did 3 days prayer and fasting and come again to sit on the judgment seat of Vikramaditya. But this time again the same thing happened. Another stone angel asked him if he had never desired to possess the riches of others. It means it was the second, and you may have a question, what did the second angel say to the king? Then you say, a second angel asked the king if he had never desired to possess the riches of others, if he did not wish to keep and take the riches and wealth of others. The king admitted that he had done so. Yes, of course, he wished, and therefore he was not worthy to sit on the judgment seat. Now, student, you know well what happened. This angel also flew away into the sky. In this way, whenever the king tried to occupy the throne, he was questioned by another angel and he asked to withdraw. The king had to accept his mistake, had to accept his sin, and this went on till one angel was left supporting the marble slab. Student, you know, there were 25 angels, and now this happened 24 times. That the angel asked the question and the king had to agree that he has a very indecent and unjust life. The king went near the throne with a great confidence. He felt that he was sure of being allowed to take his place that day. He was thinking that definitely on that day he would sit on the thing. But something was written in his destiny. It was different. But as he came near the seat, the last angel came out and became alive and asked, "Are you then perfectly pure in heart? O king, is your heart as pure as that of a child? If you are not indeed worthy to sit on this seat?" Students, I hope you came to know. It was the question of the third angel if he had a pure heart, that of a child, if he was pious in the depth of his heart. If so, he was worthy to sit on the seat. If no, then he would not. The answer of the king was, "No, I am not." And it was true. At these words, the angel flew up into the sky bearing the slab upon his head. I mean to say, when the angel listen to this king, he put this seat on his head and flew it to the sky. You know what happened now? There was no more seat now on the earth, because this last 25th angel flew into the sky keeping the marble slab on his head. In this way, this how the judgment seat of Vikramaditya disappeared from the earth forever. Students, that's why we don't have seat of Vikramaditya now. Students, there are three more most important questions there. What did the first angel say to the king? What did the second angel say to the king? And what did the third angel say to the king? Students, I would like to make you recall all these three answers. The first angel asked the king, if he had not desired to rule over the kingdom of others that were not his own, you can see here. And a second question was that if he had never desired to possess the riches of others, and third, if he had a pure heart as that of a child. Students, you will go through these answers, and this will help you a lot to face the examination, and these are very important answers. And not only this, all the lines underlined with green color are very important portion of this. Students, related to these lectures, we have prepared assignments that are related to examination and are very important. So you can collect these soft copies of assignments of each lecture, particularly from our Instagram. You can follow us mehfooz.rehmn.359. So students, you keep on watching RSE classes of English, and I hope you have gone through this lecture and you like it very well. Please like, share and subscribe our channel RSE classes of English language. Thanks.